students, in this video I would like to give brief explanation about physical chemistry syllabus in second semester. This is the physical chemistry syllabus. Like first semester, in this semester also we have four units, that is physical matters of molecular structural determination and thermodynamics and statistical thermodynamics as unit 2, and electrochemistry 1 as unit 3 and electrochemistry 2 as unit 4. These are some reference books for this semester which helps in your semester examination preparation also. Generally in this video, next I would like to discuss about unit 2, that is thermodynamics. This thermodynamics is represented with unit 2. Why? Because in first semester also we learn about thermodynamics. So that thermodynamics is represented as part 1. So in this semester, this thermodynamics is represented like part 2. Okay. Now I would like to discuss about unit 2 part 1 thermodynamics. This thermodynamics, that is unit 2, has syllabus like this. First of all, thermodynamics as syllabus on brief review on entropy and entropy changes accompanying specific process, that is expansion, phase transition, heating and measurement of entropy. Next, Nernst heat theorem and third law of thermodynamics and determination of the absolute entropy and exceptions to third law of thermodynamics. This is syllabus of statistical thermodynamics. In this video I would like to give detailed explanation about entropy and entropy changes accompanying specific process, that is phase transition, heating and expansion, that is measurement of entropy also explain in this video by me. So first of all, what is meant by entropy? Entropy is a state function. Already I discussed in first semester introduction class. Generally entropy is a thermodynamic property. We have different types of thermodynamic properties like entropy, enthalpy, Gibbs free energy, Helmholtz free energy, internal energy. Okay, so this entropy is a state function. This represented with S. Okay, generally this entropy is determined by thermodynamics of second law. Thermodynamics of first law introduce temperature, second law introduce entropy. Okay, so this entropy topic was introduced by second law of thermodynamics. If Q reversible, Q means amount of heat absorbed, heat is represented with Q in thermodynamics. So this Q reversible means heat absorbed during the reversible process at a temperature T, then the quantity of Q reversible by T is equal to entropy change of a system. Okay, generally entropy is represented with S, entropy change is represented with delta S. Delta S is equal to Q reversible by T. Generally, already I told that entropy is a state function. Then change in entropy also a state function. State function means it doesn't depend on path of a system. It only depends on final state and initial state of a system. It doesn't depend upon the direction of the amount of heat absorbed or released during the physical changes. So Change in entropy is also defined as ratio of the Q reversible by T. Okay. Generally, for units of change in entropy, Q reversible means heat. We measured heat with calories, joules, and etc. Joules is a SI units, calories is a Celsius units. Okay, temperature is measured with degree centigrade or Kelvin. Okay, so units for entropy is nothing but calorie per degree or joule per Kelvin. This is about entropy. Next, determination of change in entropy in a phase transfer reaction. What is meant by phase transfer reaction? During the reaction, the phase of your system changes from one phase to other phase. That is, during a physical process or chemical process, the phase of your system, that is solid converts into liquid, or liquid converts into solid, or solid converts into vapor, or vapor converts into liquid. So whole this process, the phase of your system changes finally. Then the reaction is called phase transfer reaction. We determine change in entropy during this phase transfer reaction. We consider two possibilities. First one is from solid phase to liquid phase, and then we consider from liquid phase to vapor phase. From solid phase to liquid phase, we represent phase transfer reaction like this. Solid converts into liquids. I mean solid interconverts into liquid. Solid converts to liquid, and then liquid converts into solid. This is a reversible process. Generally, in this case, solids changes into liquids at a fusion point. Generally, solids contains fine structure, and then it converts into a liquids, then it becomes melts, and then it converts into liquid. So solid changes into liquids at its fusion temperature. Fusion temperature or fusion point is nothing but melting point. Fusion means melting. This process requires absorption of heat. When solid converts into liquids, in this process the solid requires absorption of heat. That absorption of heat is nothing but latent heat of fusion of solid. Generally, this latent heat of fusion is nothing but if one mole of a substance melting under constant pressure at a fusion temperature T, that is fusion temperature is indicated with T fusion, and delta H fusion is nothing but latent heat of fusion of solid. Then change in entropy is given by delta S is equals to delta H fusion by T fusion, that is latent heat of fusion of solid by fusion temperature or fusion point. So from this equation we calculate change in entropy when solid converts into liquid. Okay, then liquid converts into vapor phase. I mean liquid phase converts into vapor phase. Then we calculate entropy change by this equation like this. Delta S is equals to delta HV by TP. Here delta HV is nothing but latent heat of vaporization, and TB is nothing but boiling point. Okay, TB is nothing but boiling point. This is expression for change in entropy of a solid converts into liquid. This is the expression of change in entropy when a liquid converts into vapor. In both cases, change in entropy gives a positive value. Why? Because generally solid converts into liquid or liquid converts into vapor. This is a spontaneous process. In any spontaneous process, delta S, that is entropy, gives a positive value. That's why in both cases, entropy, that is change in entropy, gives a positive value. Next, entropy change when a van der Waals gas is heated and expanded simultaneously. Already, already I'm explaining this topic in syllabus, that is entropy changes accompanying specific process, that is expansion and heating. Now I would like to explain that particular topic, entropy change when a van der Waals gas is heated and expanded simultaneously. To consider, I mean to determine that entropy change in heated and expanded condition, consider n moles of a van der Waals gas. Particularly, we consider van der Waals gas at temperature T1 and pressure P1. Let this gas to be brought at new temperature and pressure as T2 and P2. From the combination of first law and second law, from the combination of first law and second law means, generally we have first law, that is dq equals to du plus p du plus dw. Here du is nothing but internal energy. In this case I represent with E. Du is nothing but dE, internal energy, change in internal energy, plus dw. Dw means work done, work done by the system. Work done by the system is represented like this also, PdV. So dq equals to dE plus PdV. Generally that heat required for the system is applied in a reversible manner. That's why we represent Q like reversible, dq in reversible condition. This is thermodynamics of first law. Generally second law we have ds equals to, that is change in entropy is equals to dq by t. So we multiply that particular temperature term with entropy, we get tds is equals to delta q reversible. So from thermodynamics law 1 and 2, we finally consider like this, TdS is equals to delta Q reversible is equals to T plus PdV. This is equation 1. Generally internal energy is a function of temperature and volume. We differentiate the above expression with respect to temperature and volume. I mean we apply partial differentiation to this equation, we get delta E dE is equals to, first of all we differentiate with respect to temperature, then volume is considered as a constant, and then we differentiate this function with respect to volume, then temperature is considered as a constant. Generally internal energy change with respect to temperature at constant volume is nothing but CV, specific molar heat at constant volume. So we replace dou E by dou T at constant volume by CV. Okay, delta E, that is dE is equals to CV dT plus dou E by dou V at constant temperature dV. This is equation 2. Substitute equation 2 in equation 1, we get this equation 2 in equation 1, that is dE is replaced by this equation 2 term, then we get TdS is equals to CV dT plus dou E by dou V at constant temperature into dV plus PdV. We common in this both terms as dV. Then we get ds is equals to cv by t into dt plus 1 by t into dou E by dou V at constant temperature plus p into dv. This is equation 3. already we know that van der Waals equation for 1 mole of gas is like that, P plus A by V square into V minus B equals to RT. This is a particular condition with respect to internal energy and van der Waals gas constant relation, that is dou E by dou V at constant temperature is equals to A by V square. In this expression, we replace A by V square with dou E by dou V at constant temperature. Then we get P plus dou E by dou V with respect to temperature as a constant is equals to RT by V minus B. RT by V minus B. Okay. Then equation 3. From equation 3, we replace P plus dou E by dou V at constant temperature term with RT by V minus B. So, from equation 3, dS is equals to CV by T into dT plus 1 by T. This whole term is replaced by RT by V minus B. Okay, RT by V minus B. So, finally, we cancel temperature term present in numerator and denominator. We get dS is equals to CV by T into dT plus R by V minus B into dV. So, now we apply integration to this equation by using suitable limits. Then we get integral S1 to S2 dS is equals to integral T2 to T1 CV by T into dT plus here CV, V present at description, okay, plus R into limits over V1 to V2 1 by V minus B into dV. This is like integral dx. Integral dx is equals to x. So, we find this integration term as s. Apply limit, then we get s2 minus s1. I mean, substitute this upper limit and lower limit, we get s2 minus s1 is equals to cv is a constant term, and then apply integration to 1 by t term. Integral 1 by t into dt is nothing but log ln t. So we get cv into ln. Substitute this upper limit and lower limit, we get ln t2 minus t1 plus r is a constant term. This is like 1 by x. 1 by x integration is nothing but ln x. So ln v minus b, and then we substitute this upper limit and lower limit, we get ln v2 minus b minus ln, sorry, minus v1 minus b. Okay, and then s2 minus s1 is nothing but change in entropy, that is indicated with delta s is equals to CV ln T2 by T1. This is like ln A minus ln B, that is formatted as ln A by B plus R into ln V2 minus B by V1 minus B. By this equation, we finally calculate change in entropy, that is delta S, by knowing the value of van der Waals gas constant, that is B. From this, we finally calculate or measure change in entropy during phase transfer reactions and heated and expansion conditions also. Thank you.